Well, the road's starting to get a little bit rough down here. But we just had a first sight of Lake Eyre, and from the top of the hill there, it looked like a complete ocean. It was unbelievable. I'm hoping we'll go over a rise up here and see it again. It's in red dirt, in red desert, and now we've come across all this black dirt, like a set of mountains just before it, and a bit winding in and out of it. And we'll go up over this rise here, and you'll see.
Oh, we're actually driving into this black stuff, Glenn. Is it black or red?
It's dark red here, but it's black beside us. This will be the most unbelievable sight over this hill. Have a go at this.
Look at that. You can see it off in the distance.
It is just a huge, big ocean of water out there. Absolutely incredible. We're heading down to Halliday's Point at the moment, where we're on this bay. And I'm going to camp on the water's edge, we're told. So we're going to have a bit of a look down here and set up for the night. Well, here we are on the edge of Lake Eyre, right on the sunset. You can see the purple and the pink hue in the sky. And we're just driving right around the very edge of the Lake Eyre.
So we've got a chance to the overflow.
You can see the water a bit further over.
Near the road, but no one's going to come.
Camp spot's a couple of k's up ahead, so we're starting to hear a little bit of chatter on the radio. No, road's a lot better here than it was back there.
Good times are worth more than money any day. That's what I always say. That's what I always say. That's what I always say. Got a letter, made me lose heart. Gonna have to make a new start.
Well, we're here at Lake Eyre, and Glenn's decided he wants to find out how far he can go. And it's not looking so good. I'm going to stay on the dry salt. But Glenn's decided he wants to go and touch the water, I think. I don't know whether he'll make it. Maybe he should have done up his shoelaces before he left. Oh, almost slid out then. No, if you go in there of your own volition, you can stay there.
How soon before the tide comes in?
Touch the water. Can you see fish? The water. He's going to keep going. Dear, this could be bad.
Lake Eyre water, all the way from the Gulf of Carpentaria. It's turned up here. Ended up in this muddy sinkhole.
And then we've got a seagull circling behind him. Where's he going to put those shoes now? That's what I want to know.
That's amazing. I think how far that water's come to end up here. They say that the basin here, this Lake Eyre basin, is larger than the state of South Australia. Pretty big.
Absolutely
incredible.
I that's what I always say. Good friends are worth more than money in the bank, that's what I always say. That's what I always say.
Drums if you set up properly. A lot of dust. But we're at Halliday's Point.
Halligan's Point.
And that's named after a bloke in 20 or 29 or 25 or something. Knew there was water out there, but didn't know how far it up was, so he bought himself an aeroplane down here and he flew out there. And he proved to everyone there was actually water. It was an inland lake in here, and he came back with evidence and proved that there was actually water out there. Out beyond us over there is ABC Bay, and that's named after when the channel ABC turned up in 1976. And when the big floods were on, this whole area was really badly flooded. The ABC turned up to film it, and they did it just over there. And ever since then, they call it the ABC Bay. Nothing special about that one. But we were coming out a little bit. I've been out for a walk out of the water. Absolutely fantastic spot, well worth the drive out. See you at some time.
White soul will be forgiven. I know whatever happens, let
down the road from Williams Creek now. We're about 60 k's short of Maree. We've been past the South Lake Eyre lookout, and you can see water off in the distance, but it's a fair way off in the distance. This road's pretty dusty, and not without surprises actually. It looks nice and flat. You get a bit of pace up, there'll be some potholes which you'll dream about tonight. Plenty of traffic out here, quite a bit of oncoming traffic. We've done a little bit of overtaking every now and again. We saw the funniest thing not long ago though. We saw a dual cab Mazda Bravo towing a catamaran, loaded 16 foot Hobie catamaran. And that trailer, I don't know how he got it this far, but I don't know how much further he's going to get it. There must have been about 70 rolls of duct tape all over that thing. And this mast was just on these numbers all over the roof of the car. It wasn't looking good at all. Good luck to him. He wants to sail that Lake Eyre proper.
Some full on desert.
It's a totally different type of desert out here, that's for sure.
Up in the distance here you can see a railway siding. There's been a lot of ruins from the old Gan.
More money in the bank, that's what I always say. That's what I always say. Good times are worth more than money any day. That's That's what I always say.